Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of FlowScape. And I'm so happy that you guys just love this series. So who am I to not continue this awesome game? I keep calling it game, but I don't know. As I mentioned in an earlier episode, I have no idea why the top border and the down border are gone or missing. So I will just make black bars on the side so you can at least see it, but it's so weird. I don't know why it happens. It's probably something in the game, or I don't know. But anyways, wow, so many comments. I was reading them and I was like, okay, I just really have to reply to them. But before I do, there was another update last week. As you can see, there are like these big areas of land. I have no idea how to call them right now, but so you can really create your own landscapes more. Like, it would still be amazing to have just a terrain tool. I don't know why that is in, because it felt pretty hard to put down like the flowers and the bushes, like the alignment. It felt a little bit weird, so hopefully that will be changed in the future. As you may have noticed, they are updating a lot of times, so it's really amazing. I can't even think of what this game will look like in just a few months. So last week, I think it was last week or maybe 2 weeks ago, we had an update again, 1.2, and this added these big terrain thingies and also dragons. Oh my goodness, dragons, guys. Well, a dragon, I think it's just one, but of course I just really wanted to put down that dragon because I just love all the fairy tale. Like, I didn't want it, like, it looks very gray and blackish right now, but it's gonna be very green because I just really love that. I just can't help it. So I just really wanted to have a nice and fairy tale environment, but still have like a dragon that doesn't look like super nice, as in like not super kind dragon. Oh my god, what am I rambling? So yeah, but let's just jump into your comments and you guys can watch the video together, and hopefully you still like it and everything I just said makes sense. So there were so many. Oh my gosh. Thank you guys so much for all your amazing comments and replies. The first one is from Poison Blade. You said, this looks absolutely stunning. You, the lady, are absolutely amazing and far too humble about your skills. Of course, hope you and everyone here have an amazing day. So yeah, I just really wanted to pass this message to every one of you. I wish everyone an amazing day, even though we're just starting the video. So we're not ending, please stay tuned, okay? Hydra Extreme said, will there ever be a new The Lady in Wonderland episode? Obviously it's not about FlowScape, but hopefully I made you happy with the video I posted this week with The Lady in Wonderland and a new update. So yes, there was an episode incoming. Hopefully you enjoyed, Hydra. Maxwell Clark says, I would love to see them expand on the type of animals you can add to the landscapes. African savanna, Amazon jungle, prehistoric and mythological. I'm sure people can agree with me on this. Well, at least I do. Like, I would love to have so many animals. Like, seriously, a lot of animals in this game. It's amazing to use these animals because it brings your landscape alive, and it's nice to have a good variation of animals. So yeah, of course, I definitely agree on that, and I'm pretty sure that everyone who plays this game does agree with that. And also, the developers of FlowScape are still working on the game, so yeah, I'm pretty sure they are at least working on a few animals. Who knows, maybe if more people ask for more animals, that we will get more animals. That would be amazing. Timothy Y says, I design in Unreal Engine and I wish I could iterate on my landscape as quickly as this game. This game is super quick. Like, this scene alone, I created in like less than an hour. It's crazy, like seriously crazy. You can create so many beautiful things in so less time. And also what is really funny is like, the time you spend in the game just to create like delighting and stuff, it takes you maybe even longer than creating the landscape. Not because it's like hard, but just because you're like, oh, let me try this and let me try that and let me try this lighting and let me try that lighting. So it's amazing. Like thinking about that, it would be amazing if you could create like a rain scene with like thunderstorms and lightning. That would be so awesome. So devs, if you're watching, because you commented on my last video, so hopefully you are watching this one too, lightning effect would be super amazing. I don't really know how you would implement it, like thunderstorms or that kind of things, or rain, but it would be so amazing. Like the mist and the fog in this game are beautiful, like beautiful. You will see it in the cinematic shots. I really tried to play with that. It's so amazing, and I can't even imagine like if you have a rain scene or thunderstorms, oh, that will give such an amazing environment. So yeah, it's amazing to play with the lighting effects at the end when you've created your scene, like really, really awesome. Miss Kurijama said, this game is just made for you. Let your creativity run wild now. Oh yes, definitely agree on that. It's so satisfying, and the music is just beautiful. Like, all the music you hear right now is from the game. I'm pretty sure, like, the last update, they added new songs, but I did record these myself in one of the first versions, so I should go back and record a few more songs of the newer version, because I think that was some new music in there, but the music is just so relaxing and satisfying when you're building your scene, so yeah, definitely amazing to be creative and just have fun. Davros Gaming says, you are amazing, the lady. You're so talented and artistic, and I can't wait to see the next episode and see what you come up with. Well, Davros, I hope you enjoyed this dragon scene we created. I still haven't really played with like all the buildings you got. You got like so many standard, you can see the option on the right, you can create like castles and like little villages scenes with that, and like little boats in the water, but I don't know, I just really feel at this point to create more of the landscaping. I really just enjoy that, but there will definitely be a moment where we're gonna create like little villages and that kind of stuff. So there's so much more to try out with this game. It's really amazing, and if you really want to see more of those buildings, you can just try to find FlowScape on YouTube, and they have like updates videos, so you can see what is new in the game, what we haven't tried yet, because it's really amazing. Hydra Extreme, those move rotation options controls look exactly like the ones from Planko. Yeah, it's not like, if it would be easier if you had like keys. I'm not really sure if they are in the game, but at least I don't know them. But let me make that clear, I didn't really look at the control keys. But yeah, it definitely looks the same like Planet Coaster. It will be I wanted to say it will be nice to have an alignment tool, but we do have that, so I'm lying here. We have an alignment tool. Oh my god, so many comments in so less time. We're already at the cinematic shot, so we're gonna do a few more. Swissa said, that will be the quality we need in Planet Coaster for landscaping. I mean, trees and stuff, just imagine. Yes, and all like the rocks falling down and the leaves and the branches and everything. That will be so, so amazing. But I can see FPS going down really, really quick in Planet Coaster. Okay, one more. What settings are you using to get in close? I think it's the field of view, what you mean. So if you play with the field of view, you get like different zoomed options. I don't really know how to explain it in English, but like photographers have that too with their lenses, so definitely something to look at because it can create really stunning views. Okay, I'm gonna leave it to there. I'm so sorry if I didn't reply to your comment, but thank you guys so much for all your replies, and enjoy the last few scenes of this video, and please leave a like at the video if you enjoyed. Subscribe, of course, if you already haven't. My name is DeLadysigner, and I thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope to see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.